Hello everybody, and welcome once again to Running Red, the hardcore questing mod from Gideon Seymour. So, at the end of the last episode, I created these particle generators and other items for the complex spells, and I didn't claim the reward, I don't think. In fact, I've already got one reward, if I look at this one, an epic reward back from something else, and I can't remember what it was, and two half hearts, so let's take those first of all. And right, my epic reward bag was 16 copper orbs. Not really so epic these days, but better than nothing. Let's put them into this hopper here. We'll put this over here. I don't need to at the moment. I've got plenty of hearts, like 24. Maybe I'll need it later on. And let's go and look at the reward bag. Right, that was this one here. I haven't done those yet. Let's go back. Yes, this is the one I completed. This was to kill a wither. So I killed the wither, so I can now claim the reward. And just to prove I killed the wither, I have another star up here, so there we are. And yet, of course, a fifth divination sigil of the other type. So let's put this yellow heart canister in place, so we now have 15. And what else? Let's have a look at this again. So now we can do that one. So that should now open up a second one, but maybe these are dependent on here completed this route. So let's look at this. This was the long fall boot. We need to make two long fall boots. Okay, it's fairly straightforward. It's a little bit expensive on my diamonds at the moment. So it's two diamonds, one obsidian, and six iron ingots. So let's do those two. We have to do two. That's actually a right drag, by the way. And obsidian. I don't have any obsidian in that chest. Never mind. Obsidian, I have no shortage of. And we'll just put these two obsidian in here. We should have two longfall boots. Now let's check the quest book again. Now it's completed. So now we've got to do drinking by the cemetery gates. And this is a task where we have to do another crafting. So we have to make now longfall boots, one of. Okay. As far as I'm actually aware, that is simply made by two longfall boots. Like this, longfall boots. Right click, so that's now completed, and now I can claim the reward, and we get another yellow heart canister and 16 golden apples, which is actually rather good. I actually can't see the point in the long fall boots except to complete the quest, so let's go and put those away somewhere. No, we'll put them in the other chest here. It's less, got less junk in it, and we shall then have a look at what we got. So we need to put this heart canister into place, and we'll do at least 16 golden apples, which we can go and put around the back in the store of golden apples. Yes, it's here. Now we've got 52, very nearly full this case chest. Let's have a look what we've got to do now. So now we've got all the way. We are all bullets. No, sorry. All we are is bullets completed. Ah, this was to make an energy blaster. So I can claim this reward straight away. That was a very easy one. And the next one here, life is a dream for the dead. Repeatable quest. And here we make, what do we have to make this time? This is actually a witchery one. Dream of Weaver's Nightmares. So we just have to have these in that inventory, and we shall get icy needles and brew of sleeping. Dreamweaver of Nightmares. I'm not sure how to do that. I shall go and quickly look it up and see if we can do it. Quickly, that is. It must be this one here. And it's a craftable item, so we needed some tormented twine. Yes. An item frame, That shouldn't be too difficult. One leather and sticks. We could probably make that straight away. I've only got six sticks. I'll need to do it like this in that case. Oh, in fact, I think those are impregnated sticks. Yes, they are. That won't help. So we need another two, don't we? I'm not going to be able to complete this quest for a while because I need to make all the witchery items that go in the process. So splash potion of night vision, that shouldn't be too much of a problem. So that's one gunpowder with a potion of night vision, which is redstone. Okay, which is a golden carrot. An awkward potion. Awkward potion, simply netherwort. Okay. And this one is one carrot surrounded by gold nuggets. That's fairly straightforward. We need nine gold nuggets. We only get... Oh, actually, we need eight gold nuggets, don't we? So I'll just take one of those. We need a carrot. Oh, we got... Actually, carrots, oddly enough, in this chest here. In fact, what I also want to do is I should slay a few mobs so that we get... complete the next quest, that repeatable one with the diamonds, since I've got no more diamonds left. And this should complete that quest and make it a bit quieter. As you can see, there are a lot of mobs in here. Right. In fact, if I remember rightly, I also put up another hive in here as well. This was a scented hive. Let's take this out of the way. We don't need that there. Yes. So now we have that. We have a carrot. And nuggets. So we can quickly make a golden carrot. A brewing stand we've already got. Bottles of water we can make. So that's what we'll do with the bottles of water, we'll make three. You never know, these things actually come in handy sometimes. So three bottles of water, which we can come over here and fill those up. And the brewing stand we can come over here. Put these three bottles of water in the brewing stand. With some nether wart. Well, I'll quickly get another wart. Four from one. Put the other one back and put the others over here. Yes, I can put. Oops, I wanted one of those, not all of them. There we go. So now I put this nether wart in here, and then I should end it with awkward potion. And then it wants, what was the flight potion? Splash potion of night vision was gunpowder, which we got stacks of. This one, that was to increase the time. Redstone always increases the time, so from 3 minutes to 8 minutes. And just one golden apple, carrot, apple. So that processes way down, and when that's finished, we get awkward potion, and we just put the carrot in here. Seems to be taking its well time. Yes, I thought it was just a gooey bug, because it doesn't take very long normally for these things to do it. I wanted one redstone. I should probably actually have in that chest beside it anyway. And one gunpowder, which we've got here from a few of those slaying those mobs actually, so. Okay, one redstone. Actually, while I'm waiting for this to brew, that should be done now. And then the last thing we need is a splash potion. So it's always more economical doing three at a time. In fact, I'm not quite sure why I want 3 bottles of splash potion, but we'll take them anyway. There we go. 3 bottles of splash potion. We shall put 2 of the bottles in here. We only wanted 1, didn't we? So that looks a bit strange. Let's sort that. So, what was I doing? Right, that's splash potion, night vision. This is the one that's going to be a bit more awkward to do. That's why I needed to kill the mobs, because that's diamond vapor. And diamond vapor is a diamond with some oil of vitrolet. And these have to be done in the witch's distillery in a clay jar. Clay jar is fairly straightforward. 3 soft clay jars, which is just this pattern, and we have absolutely tons of that. So let's go and do that. But I have to make a witch's oven and a witch's distillery. Okay, maybe we have time to do that. So clay should be in here. Good. So 27, really could do 28. It's divisible by 4, I hope. We just put these out like this. Got 28 soft clay jars, which we then cook to make clay jars. That's fairly straightforward. Just stick them in the redstone furnace. And then we also need to make a witch's oven. Did I see that there? No. Ah, here we go. A witch's oven. So that's fairly straightforward. Bars, 9 bars are simply, I think, is it 9? No, that's a block. Is it 6? I forgot what the iron bars are. Let's have a quick look at that one. In fact, let's have a look. Witch's space oven. You can hardly see it. That's what our problem was. So, it is just 6 like that. So we take these out. And we'll actually need some buckets, didn't we, I think. We'll take 1. What else did we need in this recipe? It's hard to see, isn't it, this one? Okay, so we have enough now. 1 bucket, 1 bars, and some iron ingots. 1 witchery's witch oven. So the other thing actually to do with witch ovens is these smoke tubes, I think they're called. I won't be exactly sure. So let's have a look at. Here we go. I think these are fume funnels is what we need. A filtered fume funnel and a fume funnel. So that would be a fume filter. Okay, that we cannot do yet. But we can do a fume funnel. So that's fairly straightforward. Blocks of iron. Okay, we can have 2 of these on 1 oven. So let's do that. Glowstone, I don't have any glowstone in there. In fact, iron ingots we have. We need, how many buckets do we need there? 4 buckets and a bucket of lava, so 5. So we don't really have enough, so I need to get some more. Let's do that. I can't see any buckets of iron. And I've actually got lots of blocks of iron. Oh wow, I've actually got a rocky hive. Fantastic. Do you know, I didn't even know what to think that was actually going to be possible. So I should have on me my boots. Yes, so you got plenty of iron, but iron ingots in there, and oh, only 1 block of iron in there. Oh, that's not very much. I thought I'd got more. I'm looking for my sigil of, not the Green Grove, air sigil will be the one I want. Let's go flying up here. That was good for a change. And we want some more iron. Actually, we can do it easily enough here, I suppose. So let's do it on here. We need 1 more block. We only need 2 blocks of iron in this, don't we? And we need just some buckets. We needed 5, so we've got 3, so we just need another 2. And that should be enough for the fume funnel. We need now 2 buckets of lava. Let's get those quickly from behind here, if I can reach actually, which is now a bit awkward. That's that, and the fume funnels. The recipe for the fume funnel was this one. Oh, I still haven't got everything I need, have I? I haven't made anywhere near enough buckets. That was very clever of me. But, because we want to make 2 of these, so I need another block of iron and some another set of buckets. Right, okay. I'll do that over here because I've got some space over here. So we were 1 bucket short, so we need 5, so we need 6 buckets, don't we? Oh, that'll give me 8, so let's take 2 off there. Like that, and that'll give me 6 buckets. And we don't have enough iron in there for another. I'm doing really well, aren't I? Let's go and get. But we have plenty of iron. And I'm sure I've got plenty of iron over. Oops. Over in this chest. Anyway, yeah, 34. I'll take those ingots as well. Nice big bang from the creepers exploding. Right, here we go. And we need 2 of those. And we need, now all we need was some glowstone, which I've got here. I need 8. And I can just simply craft that one myself, I think. 2 glowstone blocks, yes. That's glowstone dust. So right now I have the 1 fume funnel, 2 fume funnels. Actually, they do stack. Now, I've got to put these down somewhere. And I'm not sure. Let's do it over here. This is a reasonable place, plenty of space. So let's put the witch's oven down first. And beside that, let's put down these 2 fume funnels. That's how that works. And we also need to make a distillery. And I'm also looking a weeny bit hungry. Let's eat as well. While we go and get the ingredients ready for the distillery. So I think I'm still at the witches. Now, a distillery, where is that? Ah. Oh, right, 1 attune stone. So that's a whiff of magic. A whiff of magic is a rowan sapling, which we do have, in the witch's oven. And with a bit of luck, that will give us a whiff of magic. So, the first thing we need to do... have I got another lava crystal? I think I have another lava crystal. Yes, here we go. That's a good way to power the witch's oven anyway. And what did I want from in here? Nothing, I don't think. Oh yes, I wanted the clay jars. So let's have a look at this. So that one is not yet bound, so we need to bind this one. Now it should be bound. Yes, current owner. So we can put that into the here as the cooking item, and here we can do that. So now we need a rowan sapling. Well, we have plenty of rowan saplings. I don't have the others yet, but I do have rowan. But they're not in there, are they? Here we go. Oh no, I've got alder saplings. Well, I need to make some rowan saplings first. Okay. So what we need from that is, I don't know where I've got it in these chests. Oh, I know where it is. I need some Mutandis. Wrong chest, it's a wooden one. So here's Mutandis. And the way I've been making Mutandis, by the way, the recipe for this one that I've been doing, is this is a bit complicated, but there's a much easier one where you can stick it in a tier 2 altar with 3,000. 33,000 LP, just bone meal, and we'll get Mutandis out. In fact, while I'm doing that, let's make some more. bone meal. I have stacks of bone meal somewhere. Here we go, 42. In fact, let's just grind up that other bone. 45. I'll do. Hopefully by the time we finish we will get a rowan sapling. In fact, we need more than one. So let's have a look at this. Put in those. Take out the orb. And first of course, move this out of the way. Take out the orb. Put the orb back in here. The next time. And hopefully those will then cook. And give us some mutandis. So let's take the mutandis here. I've only got 16 at the moment, which may or may not work. And what we do, if you don't know this already, is to put a sapling down, hit it with mutandis. In this particular case, I've got grass. Well, that's not really useful. Let's do the next one. And here I've got an alder sapling, and right click it again, and then I've got hawthorn sapling. Super. That's one of the witch's ones. We'll keep doing this. I've got another one of those. I don't really care about that. Oak sapling, mushroom. Okay, we can have a mushroom. Brilliant. Flower, a birch sapling, glint weed, a lily pad. I don't know if I'll keep a lily pad anyway, because I'm not sure how you get those to work. Grass again, rose, lily pad again. A hawthorn sapling, two hawthorn saplings, actually that's good, but another hawthorn sapling, I'll keep those. And my last one, a spruce sapling, well, brilliant. So I've now run out of mutandis and haven't got what I need yet, a rowan sapling. So let's go and try it again. We have an absolute massive bones. Let's just grind up some of these. And efficiency is not important. So I've got three stacks. And let's stick some more of these in here. Actually, let's have a quick signal. Sigil of magnetism. I don't want. I want the divination sigil. That's in slot six. It's actually slowly going down, but that's probably because I'm here. So let's stick the rest of those in there. Get out of the way. So the mobs can spawn. The mobs will be spawning anyway because I've got these cursed earth in there, but I did show you that before. In fact, while we're here, let's go and get these bees because that's obviously going to take a while to do. I think it's in here. Scoop. And I also would like to have these scented hives. Great. I can put another scented hive in here and hope I get another one. The reason I want rocky bees is because they're nocturnal and they also have a reasonably high. Let's get these. Let's put on the seal of magnetism. Right, picks up the bees and put down in here another scented hive. Let's have a look at our two bees. We've got a rocky and a pristine rocky. That's really, really good actually. Pristine bees are much more useful than ignoble bees. So let's have a look at this. So we have a short lifespan, that's also good. Fertility 1, that's actually really bad. And it likes rocks as flowers. That shouldn't be a problem for it. But it should also be... It's resilient in temperature, humidity, and it works in nights and flies and works in caves. So it's rather good. But we have, first thing we have to do with this is to breed it into something more useful. And what we have in here at the moment, it's got his light on, so that means it's run out of something. There's some more bees. So while I'm going to do this, I'm going to have to put some of this stuff away. So look at the rocky drone as well, because I haven't done that yet. Five. Yes, this is exactly the same problem with this bee, as it has this. It does have these possibilities of a rocky cone. But what's good about it is the night properties. And this chest is now full. Fantastic. So I'm going to have to put these two bees in here and try and breed a better version of the rocky drone, or at least get some of the properties. Nocturnal will be good, but it's not essential. So now I need to analyze these bees here. In fact, well, before I do that, let's get rid of this, the usual problem, full inventory. Is there anything in there I can put in there? Not really. I'll sort that out a bit. In here, maybe, yes. Let's take out, see, this is all elder wood. I wanted to spruce. I thought it got hawthorn wood on as well. And, actually, let's put the lily pads in there. Arrows. To get rid of those in the right place. Last potion of night vision, let's go put that as well away. It's amazing, this particular game. It really is always doing the same stuff. I should put that as well away. Let's put these in here. If I've got enough space in this chest, which I have about. So what I'm trying to do is to produce this witchery stuff, don't I? So let's get these things out of the way that I don't need it from there. Okay, let's now get rid of the other stuff. And of course, if you've got some Mutandis at the same time, that would be rather good. So let's that one and that one. And here we go, some Mutandis. So let's just take these other 45 out. We don't need those at the moment. And realize we don't need it either. Let's take those. Oops, vacuum up. I have to remember to click the right one. So now I stand a reasonable chance of getting a rowan sapling. In fact, we need two. See, these alder saplings have already grown. Oh, hawthorn saplings have already grown up. Let's try here. It's just a question of a fern. Oh, well, maybe we keep a fern. Spruce sapling we don't need. Oak sapling don't need. Hawthorn sapling we don't really need. Another lily pad. Oh, goodness. Alder sapling. Ah, at last. A rowan sapling. I think that's almost all of the different things you can get. That's just, I'm not 100% sure. So, a dead bush, yeah, brilliant, huh? What am I going to do with a dead bush? Nothing. Fern, rose, a Spanish moss. I've already got Spanish moss, but that's actually quite useful. Try again. What happened to the Spanish moss? Did it just disappear? Probably should have cut it down. Oh, we got some more Spanish moss. So let's take our shears and cut the moss down. There's actually another witchery item, so a jungle sapling. Okay, I got another one of some over there as well. So that's actually quite good. Another hawthorn sapling. Actually, we'll keep those as well because we don't have very many of those. Old sapling, spruce sapling, grass, hawthorn, spruce, another glass brook. Oh, okay, that's just this one, isn't it? And another sapling, another lily pad, incredible. A another mushroom. Yellow flower, dead bush, another mushroom. Glintweed, alder, spruce. Yes, another Spanish moss. The reason you need Spanish moss is it helps with the witch's altar. Another lily pad. Well, that's one way to produce lily pads, isn't it? Another one. Another jungle sapling. Oak, mushroom, alder. These are actually quite surprisingly rare to get a rowan sapling. I didn't think it was. Oh, that's the second one. Ah, ember moth. That was another one I wanted to get, I think. And I think that was the last one. So now we've got this. Well, let's make this grow. This one, and we need our axe as well. Okay. There we go. That was just two hits. It's quite a tree, this one, by the way. It grows very fast, and you've got to watch out. I think that's all. Let's double check. Guess it's just leaves now. Now, I probably should go and get a crook. Let's go and do that. No, I don't have anything crook-like in these chests. I was hoping I would have, but I don't, so let's go. Of course, I'll find any in there. What have I got in here? I must have some crooks around somewhere. Ah, here we go. Let's take these two. Here's that ruin, so let's get this cut. In fact, it is quite prolific in terms of saplings, if I remember rightly. I've worn on those for a while, slow on. I only want to chop down that ruin, I don't want to chop down the oak tree, or whatever it is. In fact, while I'm doing this, it would also be sensible to look at this. Yes, that's okay. Divination. Probably to turn off the green groove, but let's just turn on the magnetism one. And that will pull the saplings to me. And when this one breaks. Oops, I'm digging away at the jungle sapling now. Which. Of course, what I can do with this is now to put this into a planter. And get it to planter corner. The rowan trees, and let those get harvested. Certainly a lot of them. Anyway, since that's done, let's go back over here. Now, we had to cook those rowan trees, didn't we? So let's put those. I've got 11 saplings. Let's keep one behind and put 10 in here, and hopefully. Because we've got these fume funnels on here, it increases the odds of the items. So we got our whiff of magic straight away, which is great. So while that's cooking, let's go and get rid of some of this other stuff. I've got increase of those, some of those. I haven't, guess I've got 39 in there. I'll take those 25 out. No, I'll leave those in. Spanish moss, have I got any Spanish moss in there? I don't see any. Let's take these out of here, we don't need those, and let's put the ember moss and the rowan sapling and the Spanish moss if we can get it in here. Oh, we've got an oak sapling, let's take that out because we've got oak sapling. Oh, this has been analysed by forestry, but I ain't sure what I did. I've forgotten how I did that. Never mind. Let's put this over here, and in fact I'll put the string in there for the time being. All these trees all sprouted up. Hopefully I don't have to worry about mob spawning underneath there, but you can never be sure. What did I want to put? Spanish moss away. Now the Spanish moss is exactly the same as ordinary moss. Just put it on something and it'll grow. So let's put it, for the sake of argument, on here. And that'll grow down and probably get harvested by the harvester. So that's where we were. We were doing a whiff of magic. So I got 6, which is actually quite a good return from the 10. So that's a much better return than normal. It does tell me recipes. So, for example, we wanted oil of vitrus, didn't we? So we wanted the hawthorn sampling. So it says it doesn't actually give you the percentage. And obviously the ash was, actually got one ash per run sapling, so that was good. Okay, so next. This is going to be quite a long quest, especially since I haven't been doing witchery. If I've been following witchery, this would have been quite straightforward. Let's turn off this as well while I'm thinking about it. Don't need everything growing everywhere. I don't need to collect mob stuff when I'm doing that. But I do need to check this. Let's go back. I'm sure that I probably now completed this quest I have. So now I can get my diamond. Which is fairly... Oh! Reasonable. Oh, is that an O- reward? Let's go put those away. I should just think I have got still got enough room in here. Yes, just. Oh, another half a heart. Ah, let's get rid of these as well. Half a heart, and that's just junk. What I should do is to create another chest. Let's make another chest to put the witchery stuff in it. I'm sure I've got enough wood in here. It's 12, that'll do. And I won't mess around. We'll just create straight away a gold chest because they are still in this mod pack cheap. Because gold and iron are very accessible. So let's go and put this just over here somewhere, and in it let's put our witchery stuff that we've got. Rowan wood, that's good. And mutandis, okay. And I'm going to put, yes, this lily pad with these and the apples. Got so many notch apples. I don't want to have so many notch apples on me. Let's put, just take a couple. You never know. There's always emergencies. Oh, I've already run out of time. So what I'm going to do in the meantime is to carry on doing what I'm doing and prepare all the ingredients that we need, so you don't have to be bored watching me do these things. It can be a bit dull. Maybe I'll make some more mutandis at the same time, because I've got no shortage of bones, as you can see. In fact, no shortage of blood, for that matter, in the altar, so there we are. So, until next time, bye for now.